was in heavens. He called his entire mankind and told them he wanted to create a khalifa in me. I want to create a khalifa who will represent me in the world. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created his khalifa. His name is Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, his father. By doing so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was trying to tell us that he is the most merciful and he is worth of worship. By not worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is creating a more sins, like in Jesus, like Christians. Christians are worshipping a human being. How can you worship a human being? Because he was created from dust and he will dust will remain. He was there in dust. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala there is telling us you can't worship a creation. You must worship a creator, you must worship the creator, then after you must follow the creation. By following the creation, they are guiding us through our path so that we won't go astray. So in the Bible, in New Testament or Old Testament, there in the Bible, it shows that there are lots of mistakes there. They are telling us we must worship Jesus and we mustn't worship Jesus. We must worship God. We must take 1-0 to God in order to be God. So those mistakes are there, but it's not easy to tell a Christian that a non-Muslim that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us so that we worship him. By not worshiping him, we are doing a lot of mistake. So we are being dragged to the fire of Jahannam by those who are preaching the wrong Injil that was sent to Jesus alayhi salatu wasalam. So in Islam, alhamdulillah, we are being taught that we must worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone as a creator. You mustn't worship three gods like the Christians do. They say God is three. Is divided in three times, the Son, the Father, and the Holy Spirit. How can you say that God is divided in three times? The Holy Spirit was created by God. He is the one who created the Holy Spirit. How can you say that this Holy Spirit is another guidance for us so that we won't go astray? So according to Christianity, they say if you worship none but Jesus, they say Jesus is the gate where we'll enter in Jannah, which is wrong. Because you can't say that Jesus is the gate. God is the one who will judge according to our sins by calling us like assembly, as he will assemble us, then we'll ask us our deeds. And what did you do in earth? And a lot of people will be crying, "Yo Allah, we did what you told us," but that's what they told them was wrong. So alhamdulillah, brothers of Islam, I would like to make a prayerful dua that says, "Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep his mankind strong so that we can go far." Inshallah, amen.
Alhamdulillah. Wassalatu wassalam ala rasulullahi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. I'd like to greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Dr. Shuaib, brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The topic today is the concept of God in Christianity. My first point will be, is there God in Christianity? Or is God in Christianity? I'll tell you a small story that I had to go through before I became a Muslim. One day I went to church because I wanted to be divine and pure. I went to church. When I got to church, I was a Roman Catholic. I went to church and I found the cross inside the church. So I went to the cross. There was a body of Jesus. So when I went there, I wanted to touch it. When I wanted to touch it, the father came and said, no, you can't touch God. In my head, I was thinking, if I can't touch God, then who am I going to touch? He said, no, my son. The only way you have to touch God and kiss is when on Easter day. On Easter, I went to church, Easter, all of us lined up, we went to kiss the cross. So in my head, I was thinking, if I'm kissing God, then who is ruling the world in Baban? Because I was in Manzini. I went back to the pastor, to the father. I asked him, said, then who was in Baban? Because in Baban is also a Catholic church. He told me, no, my son. God was also there. So I got more confused. Is God differently, different time, or is God just one? So I come back to the question, is God in Christianity God, or is God in Christianity more than one? Most of the time we heard the concept of God being the Son, the Holy Father, the Spirit. In my understanding, I'm a qualified economist, I'm a qualified banker, I'm a qualified financial advisor, I know how to count. So if you tell me 3 equals 1, I'll tell you you're mad. Because there's nothing like that. 1 is equals 1. Huh? I don't know if you understand me. 1 is 1. There's no 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals 1. It's equals to 3. So I reinstate my statement. God in Christianity, is there God or is there gods in Christianity? Most of the churches, they will tell you, for us, the Spirit is with us. But then you ask yourself, is the Spirit God or is just a spirit? Because in Islam, a spirit is called a jinn. So God cannot be a jinn. In Islam also, we are taught that there's only one God. Even in Mark chapter 12, verse 29, Jesus says, only one God, when he was talking about the children of Israel, that you must believe in only one God. Then when you come to Christianity, there's three gods. You ask yourself, God in Christianity, is it God or 3 in 1? So I leave you with this few words of encouragement to all of you who are sitting here, that God has chosen you, Allah has chosen you to worship only one, not 3. If God and Christianity was really God, they say God is an angel. They say God is a shaitan. A'udhu billah. If you can imagine God was shaitan, who would be ruling the world? What would happen to the world? The world would be chaos. And if God was shaitan, who created shaitan? Because God is the one who created shaitan. So for me, my stance is, there is no God in Christianity. And I would like to leave you with these words of encouragement, that only pray to one God and only believe in one God. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Elders, Dr. Shuaib, cameraman, brothers and sisters, I greet you all with an Islamic greeting. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My topic for today is the concept of God in Christianity. Concept of God in Christianity. I'm repeating this so you know we can have a better understanding, and it's a major topic. Because why? Our Christian brothers, they have the wrong understanding of God. They tend to believe that Jesus, a living human being as us, that used the toilet, that walked on the earth, that had a mother, that spoke like us, you know, they tend to take him as God. When him himself said that I am not God, I am a messenger from God, and I'm here sent by him to show you the straight path. Luke, the New Testament, Luke chapter 2, verse 21. He says, Jesus was circumcised on the eighth day when he was born. Now, that alone will tell us that God can not circumcise. And the skin that he was circumcised with was decayed. It was thrown in the sand. Now, God cannot do something like that. It's just out of the blue. It's only a human being that can do that. And another quotation, 2 Corinthians, chapter 4, verse 4, talks about, it says, the devil is God. So in Christianity, in the Bible, they candy-coated a lot of things. The word God is used in a lot of terms. For example, the angels, they call them God. The devil is called God. So how is it possible that everything they see and everything they quote is God? So who is really God for them? So for them, because if you can see the past, how Jesus was, he used to wear a long kurta, he used to have beard. That alone will tell you when he used to pray, he'll go down on his knees. Who was he praying to? The only God, the higher power that he himself used to worship. Along the way, everything was changed. Everything was changed. And if you really look at it, God cannot be tempted. God cannot be tempted. Jesus was tempted by Shaitan for 40 days. And that alone will tell you that it's not God, because God cannot be tempted. So my respected Christian elders and sisters, we should really go deep into this thing, because it's something that can really benefit us in our lives. So go back in the Bible and see, look into it, and everything you'll read there, go read it again, because you're only reading it once. So I leave you all with a humble request: recheck the Bible, because the guidance is there, but you're seeing it the wrong way. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. My respected elders, brothers and sisters, I want to greet you in the greeting. Say assalamu alaikum. I want to speak under the heading, say, the concept of God in Christianity. According to my point of view, first I want to clarify what is a Christianity. A Christianity is that group of people that they believe that God is divided into three parts. And those group believe that there is somebody who crucified and in the cross so that our sin can be washed away. And when we found that our sin can be washed away, that just person by the name of Jesus said he was crucified and he was dead for 3 days. After 3 days, and he raised up again. And my question is, if Jesus was passed away for 3 days, who was taking care of a universe? So to me, it's appear that no, Jesus is not God, as they said. And when we can continue, can look at the book of Mark 11, verse 13. It says Jesus was hungry, and he was far away. When he was far away, he saw a fig tree, and he came closer. He maybe can find something to eat. When he got there, he found nothing to eat, was only leaves. And my question is, if it's Jesus, he's become hungry. It's clear that no, Jesus is not God. As they said, Jesus is not God because he's get hungry, which means he's a human being like me and you. And when you can continue to find that Jesus was circumcised. So meaning that Jesus is a human being, because how can God be circumcised? And his tip of his thing was decayed. So meaning that Jesus is not a God, as they said. And when we can continue, we can say Jesus was crucified. When I can go back to by Jesus was crucified. So to me, it sounded as if before Jesus was crucified, what do you think has been done? He appeared, no, he was crucified so that our sin can be washed. So meaning that even if you can do whatever you can do now, maybe you can commit anything or commit murder and all those things, we can't be not have our sin, because our sin has been washed away. So then to me, it sounds as if, no, Jesus is not a God, as they say. And when we can continue to see, when Jesus is raised up again after 3 days, and some people went to his grave to see whether Maria and Maria Magdalene, when they get there, they found a cave or grave was empty. Jesus was not there. And when they look, he left a message. One of those people, the name of those people, he saw those people coming to the cave, to the grave, and he said, no, Jesus was raised up again. So, and some of those people, they didn't understand how can a human being can be died and for 3 days, buried after death, he raised up again. Even those people of that time, they didn't believe maybe they really, Jesus is God. And by these few words, to me, I think not only to me, but to all of us, it's come clear that Jesus is not God, as they say. Because they said Jesus was tempted. And the Bible says, and the Quran says, Jesus not be tempted. So this thing is come too clear that Jesus is not God, as they said. And they said Jesus was circumcised. So Jesus was circumcised. So to me, it's appeared that Jesus was not, which means Jesus was not God, just not God, because was circumcised. And my conclusion, I want to say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. I greet you all in the Islamic way of greeting the people. And then today our topic is about a God on the Christianity. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Kul wallahu ahadi, Allahu swamadi, lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahadi. This ayah is talking about Allah himself. God is one. There is no other God to be worshipped beside him. Now the Christianity, they say Jesus is a God. But in Islam, we are not agree about that the Jesus is a God. Jesus is a human being who was born by his mother. He was pregnant like other children. he came out from his womb, we can't say that is a, it's a God. Also, Jesus, he was God temptation in this earth. He facing a lot of problem. He was one of the verse in the Bible where Jesus was tempted by the woman who was fetching the water on the way, which means he facing a lot of temptation in this earth. That's why I don't agree upon you Christians. We are, as a Muslim, we believe that Jesus is one of the prophets. We got four prophets in the Islam that we have believed. We have also believe in Jesus, that is one of them. We believe in the Moses. He came with a book called Torah. We believe that Jesus, he came with a book that's called Injil. We believe that Prophet Dawood, he came with a book of Zambuk. We believe that the last our prophet, Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came with a Quran. The Quran that was the last. Even the word Islam, he tells us to be submit into Allah. That oneness of God, we're believing on it. If you say that Jesus was a God, I'm disagree with you that Jesus was a human being, was also the prophet of God. We also agree that Jesus, he performed the miracles while he was living. We also that Jesus, we believe that Jesus will come back as a Muslim. We also believe that Jesus is going to resurrect like every human being. We believe that the Islam, it's one, is going to unite the mankind. We believe all those four books was sent by the prophet. We are not agree on as a Muslim that the Bible is the word of God. That the Bible was the books what that was combined together to make the Bible, a collection of the books that combined together and they make the Bible. We are not believed. We believe that the Quran is the word of God. Because one word called kul, there is no word like that in the Bible. There is the small God. There is a woman God. There is no singular in the Bible. We got a woman God. We got a God, small God, small G. That can be not, we can't agree that the Bible is the word of God because of that. We believe all these books was sent by the prophet. Waqal dawa alhamdulillahi rabbi alameen.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil anbiya wal mursaleen. Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in amma ba'd. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hulul uqdatan min lisani liyafqahu qawli. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My topic today is the concept of God in Christianity. Allah said in the Quran, they have disbelieved. Who did disbelieve? It's a question which Allah is asking, but it goes further and says, those who take Isa, who take Jesus, is Allah. Islam, it is a religion which takes Jesus alayhi salam as a prophet. It recognizes Jesus. He is a prophet of Allah. Allah has created mankind differently. Adam alayhi salam was created from dust. As we all know, that the first creation was Adam, who was created from Turab. And Allah went on to create Hawa from Adam. Adam was created without any parent, no father, no mother. Then Hawa was created from Adam. Then after that, Allah has created you and me from a father and a mother. Then Allah, to complete the cycle, to show us his power, is he created a man from a woman without a father. This is only to prove the power of Allah, that he can do anything. That does not give Isa alayhi salam the right to be a god. Isa alayhi salam, who is Jesus, he used to go in the market. He used to eat. It means he has needs. Allah does not have any need. Allah, he doesn't need anything. He doesn't get hungry. He doesn't sleep. He doesn't go to toilet. But if we look at Isa alayhi salam, he used to eat. He used to sleep. These are the weaknesses of mankind. And those weaknesses cannot be found in the Creator, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jesus alayhi salam, he did so many miracles. He cured the sick. Jesus alayhi salam, he made someone who's blind to see. All these things were only done through the power of Allah. It wasn't from him. He also preached. If we read the Bible, you'll find that Jesus recognized Allah. He knew that Allah is there. He was a messenger of Allah. Then what did he say in John? He said, my Father is greater than all, is greater than I, or is greater than anything else in this world. So all these things Jesus is showing us. Even the time when Jesus alayhi salam was making his prayers, he used to say, our Father who art in heaven. Our Father who art in heaven. It means him, Jesus, he is among us the creation of Allah. He can't be God. So he is showing us that he is a human being. He is like us. If we read the Bible, you will find that Jesus was crucified. He died for 3 days. He stayed away from his... If he was God, it means he is away from the creation for 3 days. What was happening in the world? Who was controlling everything? The time when he resurrected, according to the Bible, he was supposed to find everything in disorder. Because we believe that Allah is the controller of the universe. He controls. Now, if there's no one to control, it means everything will be upside down. So that proves that Jesus is not God. My brothers and sisters in Islam, we must open our minds and read the Bible and understand what is written there, because this book has been sent to guide mankind. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين. والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لو كان فيهما آلهة إلا الله لفسدتا. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي اما بعد First of all, I greet our doctor and also our brothers and sisters in Islam. My topic today is the concept of God in Christianity. Alhamdulillah, Allah Ta'ala guided us as Muslims. But there are some people who are Christian. When we check about the Christian in Christianity, there are so many beliefs, there are so many sayings, you know, in the Christianity. But I just want to mention one point about them, about the divinity of Jesus. Is Jesus the God of what? Or what? So this is the one belief which Christians they believe. So when we say about this, we check all the scriptures and also we check all the logic. We find that Jesus was not a God. But our brothers Christians and our sister Christians they say that Jesus was God. Jesus is God, and also some of them they say Jesus is the Son of God. So what we get? Because some of them they say Jesus is God. Some of them they say Jesus is the Son of God. So what we can take? So for this, we need to know that Jesus was not a God. Why Allah Ta'ala explained in the Quran that Quran chapter 6 verse 103. Allah Ta'ala explained there. He said that لا تدركه الأبصار وهو يدرك الأبصار. The eyes cannot see Allah, but Allah sees everyone, everything. So in this chapter we hear that Allah Ta'ala can see everyone, everything. But we people who can't see Allah Ta'ala. But when we see now the Jesus, at his time, people, they see him. So how we can be God? In the same chapter 6, Allah Ta'ala also explained that وَهُوَ يُتُعِمُ وَلَا يُتَعَمُ. He does not need food, to get the food from someone. But we need food. So in this chapter also we hear that Allah Ta'ala does not eat, but we people we eat. So the Jesus also was eating, as we hear some of the stories that he make dua, he make prayer, he pray to Allah, and also he to increase the wine and some other things what we hear, you know, which means he was eating, he was drinking. So but Allah Ta'ala cannot drink, cannot eat. Why? Because everything is in his hands. He is a creator. So Jesus is not God. Another chapter we hear that Allah Ta'ala, in John chapter 10, John chapter 10, verse, chapter 10, there they said, Jesus said that my Father is greater than all, which means that which Father he was talking about. If he is God, but which Father he was talking about? Which means that, you know, Allah is greater than everything. He is greater than everything. So when we check in this belief that about the godliness of Jesus, that is false. There's no any, or even when we check in the logic, there's no any God. And also when we see that if he is God, now how many God will you get? If he is God, if Jesus is God, so how many God you get? That verse, he said that my Father is greater than me. So meaning there is another God. He also, we say, is God. So how many God? That's why Allah Ta'ala explained in the Quran that لَوْ كَانَ فِيهِمَا آلِهَةٌ إِلَّا اللَّهَ لَفَسَدَتَا. If in the world and in the heaven, if there were two gods, three gods, you know, لَفَسَدَتَا, the world could be perished. Why? As we all know nowadays, you know, as we know nowadays, you know, the politicians, what they do, any political person, when he become a president, he do something else. Someone, he do something else. Someone, he do something else. And someone, he needs today something. Someone need. So meaning, if there were gods, so many gods, one, two, three gods, so each and every god want to do something. Each and every god want to do something. So at the same time, it could be the, you know, the world, it could be finished. So for this, we say that God is not, I mean, Jesus is not, is not God. He is the, yes, we Muslim, we believe that he is a prophet of Allah. He is a prophet of God. And also he did the miraculous things, but with the permission of Allah. So I for this point, I leave you in the hands of Allah Ta'ala, that so that we let us try to read more, we must try to read more and know everything about Allah Ta'ala. Inshallah, wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafi al-anbiya'i wal-mursaleen. Sayyidina wa nabiyyina wa mulana Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa qala ta'ala ba'da a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Lakum dinukum waliyadin. Wa qala ta'ala ba'da a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim fi muhkam tanzil. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. Amma ba'd. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending salutations upon our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'd like to take this great opportunity to share with you, inshallah, on the topic, the concept of God in Christianity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in the Quran that He does not give birth, neither was He born. In another ayah also is telling us that whenever giving message of Islam to the people, you give them with wisdom. And if ever they don't accept, you just leave them. لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينَ. You take your religion and they take their religion. So as our topic is about the concept of God in Christianity. Firstly, we need to understand the three key words in this. The first one, we need to understand what we mean by a concept. A concept could be defined according to the Oxford Dictionary. It's an idea or a notion. And then the term God could be defined as the Lord, as according to Mark chapter 12, verse 29. It is said, O Israel, the Lord, our Lord, is one God. So from this we hear that the term God can be used as Lord too. So another thing that we need to understand and know is the term Christianity. What is Christianity? Christianity is a religion that comes after Jesus, in which most of our Christian brothers believe that Jesus was God. So there's so many things that we need to look at as far as this topic is concerned. So whenever we talk about this topic, we look at many, many things. Like in this case, Christians believe that Jesus is God and Jesus incarnate. So the concept of God, Islam, it is not really, really clear. Whereas we Muslims in Islam, we have it clear that God does not beget, neither was He born. So as far as this is concerned, there are so many things that we need to learn as Muslims, and therefore we need to teach our non-Muslim brothers and sisters. So the concept of God in Christianity is not really understood. Because how can God eat? How can God be circumcised? As in the Bible, we are also told that at one stage, God, their God, was circumcised. And at some stage, the God was thirsty. I mean, there are so many, many funny, funny things that we get in the Bible. So from this, we understand that God cannot go hungry. As also in the verse, some verses of the Quran were told that God does not sleep, neither He snoozes. So there's so many things that we need to look at whenever we're talking about the concept of God in Christianity. So with these few words, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us knowledge that benefits mankind. As we are all here, we need to try and pass the message to other people, especially to those who might not know anything about Islam, who might not know the concept, anything about the concept of God in Christianity. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us knowledge that benefits mankind. Wa hadha, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم أما بعد لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله هو المسيح ابن مريم وقال المسيح يا بني إسرائيل اعبدوا الله ربي وربكم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي My honorable chairman, my Christian brothers and sisters, and my guests, I greet you all with the greetings of the people of Jannah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Which means, peace be upon you all. You know, my respected brothers, to me, it is very shocking that you have the Bible, you read it, but still we don't understand the truth about the Bible. My topic tonight is going to be the concept of God in Christianity. God in the Bible, he says that, or Jesus, peace be upon him, when he was approached and when he was asked by his disciples, he said that, our God who art in heaven, the reason why Jesus, peace be upon him, said that our God who art in heaven, it's because he himself also, he was a creation of God the Almighty. He was created by God and he was sent in the world to come and preach to the people. If he was God the Almighty, this was his chance to tell them that he is the God the Almighty, and they should worship him. And also we learn in another chapter in the Bible that a rich man came to Jesus, peace be upon him, seeking for advice, asking him that if he wants to enter in the kingdom of God, what should he do? And Jesus, peace be upon him, having the chance also to give him or to let him know that he's God and he should worship him only. But Jesus, peace be upon him, told him that if he wants to enter to heaven, he should keep the commandments. Which commandments? That is to worship God, the only one God. The same message that Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam, preached to his people. That, oh Israel, our God is one Lord. And if we check this message, it is the same message which us in Islam, we preach to the people. If we check in Surah Ikhlas, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. Say, O Muhammad, say, Allah is one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. This is the same message that we are preaching to the people, and the same message that Jesus, alayhi salatu wasalam, told his people. Jesus, peace be upon him, he never claimed that he was God. He never claimed that he should be worshipped. It is so shameful that we see our Christian brothers and sisters today, they do things without even actually quoting the verse as well. Without even thinking, without even using their mind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us mind to use it. So we must not take the Bibles and go decorate them in the Bible. We should read them very nicely, and also we should use our common sense. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created us for a purpose, and that is to worship us. So Jesus, peace be upon him, he never did what? Claimed any divinity. In the Bible also, I read that it was there's a woman who was actually cured by Jesus. And when he was asked, this woman, what do you say about Jesus? He said, he's a prophet. He never said that he was God after the miracle. So it means that the people during the time of Jesus, they took him as a prophet, not who? Not God. Even the Bible is doing what? Is testifying that. So I'm asking all of you, all those who claim that Jesus was God, to do what? To bring a proof if really he was what? He was God. So I end by saying that sometimes we have to use our common sense. We have to use our common sense before we do what? We claim that Jesus, he was God. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all of us to the third path. Wa akhir da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa ja'a min aqsa al-madina, that the man came from the far part land of the town. Yasa'a, while he was screaming and shouting, he said, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبَعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ. He said, oh, my nation, follow the messengers. اتَّبِعُوا, follow those, مَنْ لَا يَسْأَلُكُمْ أَجْرًا وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Those who will never ask you for any profit, and they are well guided. So, if we go to the tafsir of this ayat, we find out that this kind of a person was shouting at, he was one of the shepherds in the land of Enkidok, and he was a farmer. So Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, he sent the apostle in Enkidok because there was a king which he was an idolater, and this king, he was making actually shirk against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, he sent one of his students to go and give this king dawah. So when the first apostle reached there, he talked to the king. Then the king, he rejected the message. So when the king rejected the message, the king decided that, let me take this guy and put him in jail. Then Isa alayhi salam, he came to realize to say, hey, why such and such a person is taking long to come back? He decided that, let me send